presentation is nothing, no research, no figure, nothing, everything. I'm a school teacher. So what I'm doing in my classroom, I'm going to present. So there are no research finding of others, there are no talk. Only what I'm doing in the classroom that I'm going to present. So my topic is ICT in teaching learning mathematics. I follow the philosophy of great Chinese philosopher Confucius that I hear, I forgot, I see, I remember, I do and I understand. Now most of the time, as a mathematics teacher, we do only the first thing. We keep on talking, we keep on giving results to the student, they hear, and when they come to next class, they forget everything. That is what is the scenario right now. Now, if I want to achieve these two, I see and I remember, or I do and I understand. Now, how ICT or the computer or technology can help me doing this? So, now how do I see mathematics, right? And that's why I use ICT. Now, the full form of ICT is given by, the normal form of information and communication technology, but my say that ICT is, I see it. When I see mathematics, I remember. Now, how do I see it? The question is. Here, I'm showing you a video clip. And tell me, what mathematics do you see in that? So now you've seen the mathematics. Now, since we are a mathematics teacher, we know the curve. But as a student, if you show and ask, there will be different question. There's one question which, this is pre-decided. Already programmed mind is saying that it's a parabola. But when a student is looking at the first time, it has got different question. What could be the difference question other than parabola?
Projectile.
So it comes physics. Other what else? Curve. And somebody says that angle. Which angle the missile is going? So you have another. So you show them something, a clip kind of thing, and then start asking question. When you say that projectile, parabola, then you can take it this to quadratic equation. What is the parabola? So how is the parabola? Okay, it's a symmetrical. Why is it symmetrical? There has to be a line of symmetry. If you draw a line of symmetry, suppose that line of symmetry is y-axis, there is one side left side, other is right side. What does it tell you about x? That means for two values of x, there would be one value of y. When do you get two values from one single value? When you take square root. That means you are squaring. So there has to be a square term in the expression of the equation, if you write the equation. So that's why the square gives you parabola, or from parabola, why it gives you square. So you show it and then talk mathematics. Instead of writing that just quadratic equation is ax square plus bx plus c, where a not equal to 0 and the graph is parabola. Now how is it coming? So this ICT helped you getting this. Okay. Now circumcenter. We have been telling students that the right bisector of the sides or perpendicular bisector of the side passes through one point. As a teacher, we tell, as a student, they listen and they remember. This is what we also as a student have done. Because our teacher has said that they passes through one point, we assume that since it is teacher is saying, it is true. But how? Why? How do I verify? How do I verify? So, one question, we draw a triangle, draw a perpendicular bisector and see it yourself. But as if I am a good student, inquisitiveness is there, I'll draw one triangle. But what about if it's not happening, other triangle? Drawing only one triangle doesn't give me proof or that cannot convince me. But technology can help me doing this. So, this is again based on GeoGebra, which we'll be learning. So here is a triangle. Now, what I do? I get a different triangle by dragging this, and I always see that wherever I take this, it always doesn't matter which triangle, whichever angle. So a student can verify, or if the teacher is demonstrating, we can take different triangles and show that they always pass through one point.
Not only that, we can tell, we can show them, we can exhibit what are the different position. What happens when the triangle is right angle? Where is the circumcenter? It is at the hypotenuse. Whatever the triangle is obtuse, it is always outside. So just instead of telling, what we are doing is we are showing here, demonstrating. So there's a second, I see it, I remember. A student see it, he remember that, okay, I've seen that, that this happens. So this is what technology can help us. Another example, we have been teaching students pi is a constant and irrational. This is the value. But how do you prove that it's a constant? How do you say it's an irrational number? That means the decimal expansion is non-recurring, non-repeating. How do you do it? So again, technology helped me. So I have a circle here. I'll just shift it so that number of sides is 3. I'll increase the number of sides. What happens? Number of sides are 9. I'm getting the ratio is 3.07. Let me increase the number of sides. So when I get number of sides sufficient to 4, 5, I get the first 3 guesses. Now I'm increasing the number of sides. Just tell me what do you observe. So I suppose it is 53. Just observe the digits. What is happening to the digits of this ratio? And tell me your observation.
We are closing to the value of pi.
No, don't think of pi. I'm saying that think as a student, what is happening to the decimal digits of this?
Three digits.
Okay. Now which digit is fixed?
First four digits.
So that means what I'm saying is, and now where is your polygon gone? You said there is no polygon. There is only circle you are seeing. But I said, oh no, it is not a circle, it's a polygon. I'll show you. So polygon is there. I'm approximating the circle by polygon. What is happening is I'm increasing the number of sides. What is happening? This ratio is getting constant at a certain decimal places. That's why I see that pi is a constant number. And why it is irrational? Because the decimal expansion is non-terminating, non-repeating. Every digits are changing. And this is a polygon drawn inside the circle. So the area of polygon will never be equal to circle. Area of polygon will never be equal to circle. We draw two circles of same radius. Now as I said that this is one point of intersection, this 2 point. We can draw a line, we say that. But is it a locus? Is it always a perpendicular bisector? So again, technology helped me. So this is two circles. I am just playing the animation. See, what is happening is I am drawing circles of various radius and always they are intersecting. This distance always being the radius, they are equal. And you can see that the locus is a perpendicular bisector. So this helped me visualizing things, tracing and all. And I am purposely taken only one software so that because which you are going to see today and explore, you can. So one simple software, there are so many available, but I am concentrated on one because this is one you are going to, yourself going to experience. Limit of a function. What is limit? X tends to 0 sin x upon x, 1. So normally we tell the student that this is the formula, use this formula to solve the question. Right, or for that matter any, now we say that you cancel and all, but how this limit concept, how it is one, if you try to do calculation, manually it is not possible. So what I do, I move this, and for various values of this x, I am getting value of x as well as fx. This is my function, fx equal to sin x upon x. I am getting my start value, end value, and increments are given. I am getting value of x and corresponding value of fx. As my value of x is going towards 0, what I observe is, so at 0 what is it saying is, question mark is there. That means he is not able to find the value. Value is not defined there. But I go in this and what I see is, this is 1 1 1. So, and for that matter you can take any other function as well. So by looking at this value, a child can say that, okay, what is happening to the values, and can conclude this is the limit, which is not possible on the blackboard. You can't calculate all this value for a single function, and you can change your function. Even you can, on the adjacent spreadsheet, you can tell, okay, what is happening now, look at the behavior at a particular neighborhood, a particular point, and find out what is the limit. Even if the exact value is not defined, a child can say that, okay, the values are going towards this, and that's why the limit is this. So limit concept is there. It is not that simply you cancel x, you factorize above x square minus 1 as x plus 1 into x minus 1, and then cancel, and that's that the limit is x equal to 1. So this is what you can do with help of technology. Now, okay, so this part is the second part I've touched. Explore the graph of a quadratic by changing ABC. One way is what I've been doing, teacher demonstrating, but with e-learning software and all coming, in fact, this tool can go into a student's head using tablets and all. And all teacher need to do is prepare this kind of thing. So here is what I have. I have given this to student. He can just play with this around, what happens when I change A, what happens when I change B, what happens when I change C. So what is it, what work of teacher? To create such kind of applet and create good question which can access the learning of whether he has learned or not. You ask a question. So the graph cuts axis at a distinct point when. So here in this, everything is fx is given, discriminant is given, vertex is given. And you can change the ABC, and student can do a lot of 5-10 minutes, let him play with this. And then you have a set of questions to ask. So even if he doesn't know the answer, he can, what I am saying is the discriminant is positive. Okay, he changes A and B, say what happens when discriminant is positive. He comes to a conclusion whether the graph cuts it or not, then he takes it. Second, A is positive and C negative. He keeps A positive and C negative and change values. He opts, okay, whether it is cutting or not. So he is doing himself and is learning. So that's where come, I do, I understand. So teacher is not an instrumental, teacher is not just delivering knowledge. All our work should be creating this and creating good question which facilitate learning. So this is third, I do, I understand.